So what's up and welcome back guys. So this is possibly the last part in the series, so it can either be the last video or maybe the second last. And as I promised, we'll be talking about subscriptions in this video. So subscriptions is basically just what you know, like for instance, if you're not subscribed to this channel, then you might want to subscribe so that every time I upload a new video, then you at least get it the video among your favorite there by YouTube. So okay guys, that was just by the way. Please subscribe to this channel if you've not subscribed yet. As you can see, I really have very few subscribers as of this video. I want Google to at least monetize my video. So but subscription is basically related to just that, you subscribing to my channel. So when you create a subscription to a certain thing, so that means that every time a model in Django is updated, you want to be notified in the front end. So basically that is what happens. So for instance, I want every time a new transaction is done, then the person who the money was sent to will be notified that money has been sent to you if he's online, without having to wait until the next page refresh. So that basically, if you know WebSockets, this is an implementation of WebSockets with some help having been given to you. So I think that is a lot of things I've covered. So by default, the Django Graphene doesn't come with subscription, but it gives you options over here. So I've tried all of them just to be sincere, and for me, I think the second one was the best, and that is why I'll go with it. So I'll go with this. So let us I and that is what I'll show you how to do. So you basically need to install that. Let me just I think I better use the I leave the link to the documentation over here, so it's over here. Let me pull it. So this is it. So you just pip install. Okay, as installation is being done, then we need to set up our channels. So let us go to settings. So channels, Django channels, I don't know if you know how to set up, but it's quite easy. So let us make a file here and call it router.py. So this will basically contain our routing for our WebSocket. So that is it. So let us very fast. Nope, because something has happened. So in installing that, I believe channels is normally installed. Yes, as you can see, channel was installed. So it's simple for us. We don't need to install any other thing, but we need to set up our channels. So let us go see how. Setting up channels is really easy, but if you don't know, then I want at least to show you. So you need to add these to your installed apps. So just bring channels over here to your installed apps, and then you decide what you want to use. So in this case, I'll be going with. So there's a way you have to have a messaging client, which normally is either Redis or. But nowadays from Django 3, I think, I don't know if it's Django 2 or Django 3, we have channels there be brought to you by default with in-memory for Django. But if you are in production, then you would possibly want to use Redis. But since we are in development, then I want us to use the memory one. So let us just go over here and add our channel settings just below the database, because you see, so that is everything you need to set up for channels. The rest we will do specifically for our client over here. So let us go over here. So inside your router, then you want to add this. I'll make sure I leave the link down here. Inside your router, you want to add this. So you see, I import channels. So this will add middleware so that every time somebody is subscribing, you at least know he's subscribing, because by default this will not be knowing, will not be using session, but you at least want to use session. And you see, you have to make consumer, which so far I've not made. And then you see, we imported a path. This is basically simple, so you can go check it. I leave the link to the documentation below. And then now we go to our schema. So let us first think what we want to do. We want every time a to-do is created, then instead of returning it over here the same way we know in mutations, so instead of returning it this way, then we want at least to broadcast it. So I know that is not an optimal way, but because this is something related to only one user, then you would possibly want to broadcast every time that this user creates, then you use WebSockets to notify user that he or she has added a new to do. So let us implement that. So on top here, we need to import channel because we'll be using channel. So import this channel graph. This is what we just installed. So import those. Import these and these. So these are things you need to import. And then let us make our subscription. So over here, we need to create a class called, let us call it notify to do. So every time a user creates a to do, then you want to notify. So here we are importing from channels, grabbing this one, channels.subscriptions.subscription. So we are importing, we are extending this subscription class. So, and then now let's see, what do we want to be returning? We want always to be returning a to do, which is basically what is over there. Yeah, so yeah, that is it. So we want to be returning that. So, and then here we can just make a class. So this class normally has two things. The first one is subscribe method, which is method that is called every time you subscribe. So that will at least keep you subscribed. So the subscribe method, it has a method. So, but the class obviously can take arguments, which in our case, let's just say the argument is username. So it's, I think this is not specific to this because I think you already saw us implementing it over here. And let's say it's a string. So, and it's required because you want at least, so this one will be username, which will contain, because every time you want to subscribe a user, you want to keep the record that it's this user who is subscribing. So I think that will be clear as soon as I get over there. Let's just make this static method def, and then subscribe, and then the first one is the class object, and then the second one is obviously info, because you know the info was where our parameters, and then the username, which is in our case not null, so it must at least exist, so we know that username is always required. So, and then you just want to return something like the username you are subscribing user. So, and then if username, we just have to check is not null, else none. So if username exists, then we add, else we don't do nothing. So that is basically what that condition does. So the next method is again a static method. So this static method is called publish. So the publish method takes in also these same parameters, and no, it doesn't take this. So it takes the payload you want to be sending to the user. So like, what information are you trying to pass to the user? So that is basically payload. And then another one is the info, and another one is the username, which is in our case just what we want. You don't have to include this username, but I think that it will be really nice if you return that to the user. So we can even just say username, because you want at least to be returning, so that you show user that yes, it's his. things that you are making. So publish, and then here you just return. In our case, it's so you basically do exactly what we did over here, but now it's for these, and then you just say to do's. In our case, to do, it's simple to, it's single to do this time around. It's not to do's, is just the payload, and then maybe the username is the user. That is everything for this method. So, and then there's another thing, there's a middleware that we need for us to do subscription, and that is really simple. So I'll just copy and bring it over here really quick. So the, if you go to the GitHub examples, it was given there, this, it uses exactly this middleware, and I saw it was working for me because I followed the code, and I see it's exactly what I also would want, and so I decided to just proceed with it. So this middleware is basically what will be used. And then finally, let us make the subscription class. So that is the subscription, it's just the same thing what with what we've been doing since, but now here you pass the subject to do for it to do, and then it's just basically this dot field, because you know it's just the same way actually as over here. Just say dot field, and then over here you need to add subscribe. Yeah, it's subscription, and then just, we know that our subscription is that, and hopefully, what other thing do we need? Okay. We need, if you go to the router, you see my GraphQL. We need to make this consumer. So let us really go make that very fast. So instead of just making that again, it's in the documentation. So I'll link it below. Just check below, and it's in the documentation. .py, this was where I found the implementation explaining, and then this is it. Permutation, yeah. And then you see it takes in schema, which in our case, the schema is this schema. So you might want to bring this just up somewhere here, and then just pass this schema. That is why I need to take this mutation again up. I should have seen that. So bring this schema and add it over here. So this basically will be taking care of our consumer everything. So if you go over here, instead of home, ours was called to do, so it gets this and place it over here. So let's check and make sure that our server runs. So guys, the video is already running long, so let me just leave. As you can see, I've done everything, so let me leave the testing for the next video. So just make sure that you always remember to activate your virtual environment. So guys, please don't forget to subscribe. Please help me reach at least a number that YouTube can start monetizing me. So goodbye and have a nice time.